Hello, my name is Catherine and I'm a specialist within the developer support team. Interstitial ads launching unexpectedly is a common issue we see among AdMob apps. So today we will be looking at this policy and how you can solve it if you have received a violation. Users should never be surprised with interstitial ads. Placing interstitial ads so that they suddenly appear when a user is focused on a task at hand, for example, when playing a game, filling out a form, or reading content, could lead to accidental clicks, and this often creates a frustrating experience for your users. Interstitials should only be implemented at logical breaks between your app's content. For example, at breaks in pages, changing stages of the app, or moving levels in a gaming app. This will ensure that the user is prepared to engage with the interstitial ad and not click on it by accident. If you receive a violation notification from the policy team about interstitial ads that unexpectedly launch, you will need to review your interstitial ad implementation on that app as soon as possible. In most cases, an interstitial ad has been placed at a disruptive or random time within the app. So this is easily identified and can be changed by your developer. Another common issue we see is even when an interstitial ad is intended to load at a logical time, say in between page content, but the ad actually appears shortly after a new page of content has loaded. Most often, this happens due to mobile carrier latency. To prevent this from happening, we recommend that you pre-load the interstitial ad in advance. You will find guidelines on how to do this linked in the description box of this video. Here is an example of a correct interstitial ad implementation. The user takes an action, the interstitial shows up immediately, and closing the ad takes the user to the page that they were going to. I hope this information helps you to better understand our policy around interstitial ads that launch unexpectedly. If you have received a violation notification from the AdMob policy team and have fixed the issue, you can file a review directly to the AdMob policy team through the appeal form listed in the video description. Please ensure to fill in accurate information regarding publisher ID, app ID, and issue ID, which is included in the violation email you received. Please let us know in the comments if this video has been helpful. Thank you.